YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and today I'm going to use up my last little four cabbages from the garden. These are small, as you can see. Some of them have this black stuff started on the leaves, but you just peel those old leaves off, and there's a nice little head of cabbage underneath. I'm going to treat these as two big heads of cabbage rather than four. And I know a lot of people make sauerkraut with their cabbages, or they store them for the winter. I don't have a root cellar. And no one in the family, including me, really likes sauerkraut. So what to do with the cabbages? I went looking online last year for something to do with cabbage, and I found a very interesting recipe. Let me show you. This is from cooks.com, and it was freezer slaw. In other words, coleslaw that goes in the freezer. I started looking at the recipe. I thought, this is familiar. And I went and looked up a recipe that I grew up with, that my mom always made, and sure enough, it's the same recipe. But my mom never put it in the freezer. She always made it fresh. So all those years, my mother had coleslaw that she could have frozen up, and she didn't know it. So that was just kind of cool. This is just a treasure to me in her writing, because she's been gone, oh gosh, probably 7, 8 years now. And so any recipe I have of hers in her own handwriting, it gets put in plastic and treated like gold. But anyway, I just thought that was so funny that a recipe I've always made and didn't know I could put in the freezer is freezer slaw. Now, I have tried this. I've put it in the freezer. I've taken it out. And believe it or not, because I was so skeptical, but believe it or not, it is just as crunchy as when you make it normally. You will never know it's been in the freezer. And the nice thing about this recipe is it's not as fattening as regular coleslaw recipes that take mayonnaise or maybe it's Miracle Whip, I don't know. I always grew up with this one. This one has a little bit of sugar and vinegar. That's the two prime ingredients. And so you can take it to like church potlucks or whatever, and you don't have to worry about poisoning anybody if it gets warm or, you know, like picnics and stuff. And the fact that it will go in the freezer, now I'm doubly in love with this recipe. So let's make some today. Now, something my mother never had was a food processor, and I don't have a food processor. And she used to, when she made this coleslaw, she used to cut it all up by hand. And I remember when she got a blender, and she used her blender to chop her coleslaw up, and it was just like a revelation for her. She was so excited because that cut down her workload. So I'm going to attempt and use my Vortex hand crank blender and see if I can't do the same thing, if I can't cut this up. Well, I am making quite a mess, but I'm having some success. Oh, it's a rhyme. The key to this is to cut your cabbage into relatively small little chunks, and then this really can get a good bite on it and not to overload the blender. It took me a while to figure this out, and it's working quite well. Are they uniform, you know, and really fine, like the little bags you buy at the store? No, but it's certainly going to be serviceable for what I want. And, you know, just because it's not perfect, that just means it's homemade. So I'm going to continue on here, and when I get everything ground up, we'll come back. Oh, I'm making a mess. Cat's Cradle and I were talking last night. We're both just laughing because right now, this time of year, our kitchens are just, we call them war zones, because there's canning stuff all over, and there's a bunch of stuff on the butcher block that has to be vacuum sealed, and oh. But the good thing is, winter comes, you get to relax, and then you start over in the spring. Anyway, back to cabbage. Okay, I got the cabbage all grated up, or ground up. Now, between my mother's recipe and the one that I found online, you can add a variety of other things. Both recipes say you can add carrots. My mother says to add onion. And both of them say to add some green or red pepper. I don't have any peppers on hand right now, so I'm just going to add extra carrots. Now, I'm doubling this recipe. I'll put the recipe for just a single batch in the more information. And then you can decide whether you want to, what other vegetables besides the cabbage you want to add. And what I would suggest you do is you make up just a single batch, not a double like I'm doing, and serve it to your family, see if they like it. And if they do, then take the leftovers, put them in the freezer, and leave them there for a month. And then take them out, and I think you're going to be surprised at how good it is. And having little side dishes like this on hand already made up, you know, like salad type things, that to me is going to be just a huge time saver, because I'm usually running around getting ready for work, and before that doing chores, and then trying to get supper on the table before I leave. And the more I can have made up ahead of time, the better. At least for 3 nights out of the week, that's how it is. So anyway, so I'm going to see how my blender does with the carrots and the onion, and we'll add that, and then I'll show you what other ingredients you add to it. Well, I got the carrots all chopped up, and I have to say, that little vortex blender, the hand crank blender that I have, it did a really nice job. I mean, there's a few bigger chunks here and there, but mainly, it chopped it up really nicely. And boy, this would be beautiful with some red or green pepper in here. I'm feeling bad I don't have any, but as it is, it'll work. On to the dressing. Okay, now you're going to mix up the dressing. And that's a cup of vinegar, 1/4 cup of water, 2 cups of sugar, 1 teaspoon of mustard seed, 1 teaspoon of celery seed, and I always add extra celery seed because to me, the celery seed is what makes this dressing and makes the recipe. And 1 teaspoon of salt. Now, I didn't show mixing all that up because I'm doubling the recipe and I didn't want anybody to get confused because I was adding more than what the recipe is going to say. So, and you're going to bring this to a boil. Then you're going to let it cool and you're going to pour it over your cabbage mix. And let it sit. If you're going to serve it that night, let it sit for a few hours in the refrigerator just to let everything kind of meld. And you're good to go. And if you aren't going to serve it, put it right in your freezer. As soon as this is cooled down and you've poured it over the cabbage, it can go right in your freezer. And you're going to be amazed at how good it is months later. Okay, I'm going to let that boil, and then when it cools down, I'll pour it over the coleslaw and let you see it. While I'm waiting for that dressing to boil, I just want to give a little baby shout-out to Cat's Cradle. I want to do meals in a jar, and one of the things that a lot of the dishes call for are some quick-cooked beans. Well, if you order these online, they're quite expensive compared to, you know, the regular dried beans in the store. So Cat put out a video on how to make your own quick-cooked beans. That's hard to say. And I did it. I did it with some kidney beans and some pinto beans and some black beans. And these are just plain old red beans. And basically what you do is you soak them overnight and then cook them. Now she used a pressure cooker, which I don't have. I just cooked them on the stove for about 30 minutes. And then you put them in your dehydrator and dry them. And I think they turned out beautifully. And so when I get time to put my meals in a jar together, these are going to be just great. So thank you, Cat's Cradle, for telling us all how to do that and saving us some money. And I'm very excited to do these meals in a jar. Okay, I've got the dressing mixed in. And now all I'm going to do is just let it sit in its own juices, so to speak, for a couple hours before I serve it and or freeze it. And you want it to kind of marinate, so to speak, the cabbage and the carrots and the onion and peppers if you have them. You want them to marinate in that dressing and soak up all the flavors and have it all intermingled. And it's just a wonderful light salad. It's a little different if you're used to traditional coleslaw, but I think you'll like it better. Or just as much. But go ahead and try it, and there you have it, freezer slaw. Another use for all the cabbages from your garden. Something else to do with it besides sauerkraut. That's all, YouTube. Bye-bye.